next wonderful guest, Lucy Durack, doesn't mind being called a witch. The Helpman Award winner first played Glinda the Good Witch on stage in Wicked, and now she is reprising that wonderful character for the hit musical The Wizard of Oz. Take a look.
Close your eyes, it's very easy.
Ruby red slippers, and we got our wish because she is joining us now. Welcome back to Studio 10. Watching that, and even Denise just said, you are so wonderful. That gives us goosebumps.
Yeah. So she sings like an angel.
Oh, yeah. You do.
You're so nice. You're just one of the nicest people in the world.
I think I just play nice characters.
Because it must be so fun to play.
Is.
Glinda the Good Witch.
It's such a lot of fun. And I mean I've spent like almost a third of my life playing incarnations of Glinda, really, in Wicked and now Wizard of Oz.
Is it the same character? Is she a different character?
She is. She's a lot more similar because Gemma Ricks, who is our Elphaba in Wicked, she plays our Wicked Witch, and she's pretty different. She's pretty wicked in The Wizard of Oz, like you remember from the film.
She gives me nightmares still. That she's character.
She's pretty fabulous in our production, but she is pretty wicked. But Glinda is essentially, she still is very much the good witch. She's all about goodness. She's a little bit ditzy, so we've kind of taken a bit of Glinda from Wicked and run with that a bit. And I mean, I'd probably find it hard not to after spending a lot of time doing that. But it is fun. And I get to fly and sail.
Oh, you get to fly? Yeah. Wow. Can you tell me about your dress there?
Yeah, it looks
like
amazing.
That is my, like, all-time...
You would look so good.
I love it. But tell me about it. And the hair, everything.
It's pretty good. Yeah, so I've got a blue wig. The dress itself, just the top part of the dress, has 2,500 Swarovski crystals on it.
Are you joking?
No.
2,500?
Yeah, it's pretty sparkly. And, it's pretty great. My two-year-old daughter, we brought her. We've just done the Brisbane season, and there's a crying room at QPAC, and so we took Polly into the crying room because she's a bit noisy. She's not crying.
What's that?
So mothers can bring their babies and see the show, and it's soundproof. So you're not going to upset anyone else.
Fabulous.
Is there one for adults?
Yeah. I think you can head in there if you want.
So she saw you.
And now she was at daycare yesterday, and her daycare teacher said, oh, she said that you've gone to work and you have a sparkly dress and blue hair and a stick. And I was like, yeah, that is my work. And she was like, oh, I just thought she was being really creative.
No, it's just the best job ever.
Yeah, it's a pretty good job.
But it's great.
With The Wizard of Oz, I think so many kids watch it. I clearly remember the first time I saw it, scary Wicked Witch.
Yes.
What about for you? Did it really stick with you when you were a little girl as well?
It really did. Like, I feel like every time, it's that sort of film that every time it comes on, even if you're busy doing something, I sort of have to sit down and watch it. And it's just got such a nostalgic, and I think it's got such a beautiful heart.
Yes.
And that's why it sort of does stand the test of time. But yeah, it had a big influence on me. I remember as children in like the playground in about year three, we would play The Wizard of Oz, and I never got to play any of the women characters. I was always Toto. And so it's almost like my whole life I've been like, come on, let me be one of the women.
Have you sent any of your schoolmates the tape saying I've got my revenge and now I'm doing it on stage?
Yeah, that's a good idea. I should do that.
Now you went to Wobba?
I did, yeah.
What years were you there?
Gosh, a long time ago now. I was there 2000, 2001, 2002.
Wow.
I loved it. I was lucky.
How did they keep bringing out these fabulous performers out of there? Why is it out of that place?
They just thought she was the best Toto they'd ever seen.
Oh, Hugh Jackman.
We've got a lot of Whopper graduates in our cast, actually, in the young. They're a wonderful young company. They're so great, and we're the future of musical theatre in good hands.
And is this, you mentioned that your daughter saw you in the show.
Yes.
Is this a perfect show for sort of the whole family?
I think so. It really is. When I sort of signed on, I love The Wizard of Oz, so it was quite an easy decision. But I thought it might have been, I've seen productions before that have been a bit more pantomimey. Mm-hmm. But it is actually, it's really well done. It's the 2011 London Palladium version that Andrew Lloyd Webber revamped. Mm-hmm. So it's a tighter script and he's added 5 new songs. And it's, so it is, if you don't have to have children to come and watch it, it still is, stands alone as a decent show, a good show, really good show. And, but yeah, it's the kids. And that's what's so great at Stage Door. We've had that many little Dorothys with their red shoes and their gingham dresses. It's
now,
really
we have
great.
To ask you about Sisters as well.
Yes.
Are you enjoying... have you finished that or are you in the middle?
No, we finished it and the finale aired last week and I had the most wonderful time. It was an incredible experience with those incredible women who play my sisters, and Magda Jabansky was my played my mother, and Imogen Banks, our producer, is just
isn't she fantastic.
I adore her. She's so clever and so wonderful. Yeah, it was, and we had wonderful women directors who were incredible. It was
what do you prefer? Or do you love them both?
I like the variety of it. Yeah, it's been a really fun year that I've managed, that my management have helped me so much to make sure that I can do lots of different bits and pieces.
We're doing TV where if you stuff something uphill, you don't like it, you go, all right, stop, go again.
Yeah.
Or do you miss the kind of immediacy of just knowing that, you know, that tightrope thrill where it's... all or nothing.
It feels a bit like that anyway, like, because you don't want to stuff up a take. So you're sort of trying to give it the best and also give it your best shot from the get-go. So, I don't know, I think that... I guess maybe I can't separate myself.
So you treat it like
from
a live show almost.
I sort of, I think we all do.
And Lucy, as Denise said before, you do have the voice of an angel and you're going to give us a special treat later and sing for us, is that right?
I'm looking forward to it, to sing
it. I nearly cried in rehearsal.
Yeah, we're a little warming up.
And Sydney audiences can go off and see The Wizard when The Wizard of Oz opens at the Capitol Theatre on the 30th of December. The musical then heads to Adelaide in April. Great to see you once again, Lucy, and you'll join us a little later for your wonderful performance.
Thank you.
Big round of applause for Lucy.